Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
What do you mean by the resource conservation technique? I say, how can go for resource conservation? If you remember the first class I took for sustainable agriculture and the key indicators of sustainable agriculture. So there are five key indicators of sustainable agriculture. One is your water, and second is your soil health, then your climate change, pollution, and land conversion. Right? So if you see this, your five indicators of climate change, water, soil health, pollution, climate change, and land conversion. If you think of soil, the one of the indicator, soil health, maintenance of soil health, or the soil conservation. And the top soil is the mostly fertile soil, and top soils are lost due to erosion, either the water erosion or the wind erosion. And the crop production depends upon the fertility, especially for the field crops, and the root growth remains. We do cultivation for the 20 centimeter, I've discussed, we go for the 20 to 30 centimeter. And most of the active root system remains within around 30 centimeter. And those top soils are mostly fertile soils, and they contribute to the proper growth and development of the crop. And soil is a living body, So you need to protect the soil from erosions, either due to water or the wind erosions. So that's why you are talking for the conservation tillage. Now it's a climate change because of global warming, and due to the intensive or the tillage operations go for the conventional tillage, and the agriculture also contribute to climate change by through emission of greenhouse gases to atmosphere. So it is very essential to protect the environment, to have a sustainable environment. At the same time, protect the soil from the erosion or the loss, soil loss. That is what we say conservation tillage. Now, so that means the productions without tillage, without cultivations. Can you have the crop without tillage? So this is one of the, somebody may think of, it may not look like very smooth, how somebody can produce crop without having tillage. The crops can be produced in a soil without tillage, without going for the tillage operations, we can have proper productions. If you do so, then you'll be protecting environments, you'll be protecting the soil quality. For the soil quality can be maintained for the long term, the fertility can be restored, we can go for the no tillage or minimum tillage. And by the having the no tillage, minimum tillage, we can protect the soil quality, soil resources, because soil is a living body. We need to take care of soil, but at the same time, we need to have the higher production as well as good production. The production should be maintained. At the same time, soil health should be protected. That is what is a conservation tillage. So that means no-till farming, or we can have a minimum tillage. The tillage as minimum as possible, because if you go for the conventional tillage by primary, secondary tillage, the whole tilling of the whole land, that makes a opening of the soil. Once you go for the completely opening of the soil, so there is a carbon dioxide content in the soil is around 10 times of the atmosphere. Carbon, soil is a stock of the carbon. If I have the conventional tillage, most of the carbon, the labile pool, they are lost to the atmosphere as a carbon dioxide, and that causes global warming. So that now it is the need of the hours, you can say, how we can protect the soil from the erosion, or we can have a minimum tillage, unless because we have to maintain the crop growth. In that case, if conventional tillage can be avoided, we can have a tillage as minimum as possible, so that we can have on the crop production, and we have maintained the productions, at the same time we can protect the soil health. So that is how say conservation tillage. So we can have this double mulch tillage also, one of the no tillage or minimum tillage or row zone tillage. No tillage means without tilling. Without tillage, we can go for productions. That means there are some implements are there, say no-till seed drill. The seed drills are there, we can sow the crops without having tillage operations. No-till seed drill. Or we can go for a minimum tillage or row zone tillage. That means the rows where we have to sow the crops, as we discussed earlier, as per the dibbling or the drilling method of the sowing, the places or the rows where the crop has to be sown, only those rows to be tilled and inter rows should be let as such without delays. And this is possible for the wider space crops like corn, sweet corn, or for the sugar cane, or the RRs, those type of crops having the wider spacing. Those crops, in that case, we can go for the minimum tillage, or we say row zone tillage, where tillage operation has to be confined to the rows where the crop is sown or crop is planted only. So this is the row zone tillage or minimum tillage or no-till farming that is coming into practice. So many of the developed countries, they have experimented and they have tried, because by having the no-tillage also, we are at the less machinery movement in the field. That way you can minimize, as a hard pan formation, that is the problem for the heavy machine, heavy traffic. And at the same time, the fuel also, because once you are moving the tillage operation, so you are consuming fuel. Also the tillage, through tillage, also there is emission of greenhouse gases to the atmosphere, the carbon dioxide, CO2 emission to the atmosphere. That also can be checked. So there are certain advantages having the conservation tillage. Or the no tillage, or the minimum tillage. These are the some sorts of conservation tillage. Just double mulch tillage, that is also conservation tillage. Means there is a specific implement where the stubbles are left on the soil surface. So stubbles means the roots, grasses are there left on soil surface. Once you are leaving the stubbles on the soil surface, so they do protect the soil from erosion, because the soils are covered with the stubbles, and that can minimize the evaporation. And that can minimize the raindrops, the direct impact of the raindrop on the soil particles. So that way can protect the soil erosions, and that can, having the stubbles, that can increase the infiltration of water into the soils. So stubble mulch tillage, one of the good tillage operations as a conservation tillage, where the stubbles are left on the soil surface, and it helps in the reducing the evaporation loss of water, increasing infiltration of rainwater into the soils, and also protecting soil from erosion, either from water or wind erosion. So these are the some of the advantages as a conservation tillage, or the minimum tillage, or the zero tillage, you can say. The potential for carbon sequestration, as discussed, when soil is tilled with machinery, carbon is released from soil to the atmosphere. So this, in addition to the emission of pigment itself, so increase the carbon dioxide content in atmosphere. Carbon sequestration in soil or elsewhere is a proposed method for reducing the greenhouse gas emission. So by the reducing tillage operation, leaving the crop residue to decompose where they lie, and growing winter crops can slow down the carbon loss from the field. So this is how to carbon sequestration, how to protect the to retain the carbon in the soil, because soil is a stock of the carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide content in soil is higher than the aerial atmosphere. How to protect this one through minimum tillage that acts as a carbon potential for carbon sequestration. So now also many companies, you might have heard that they are buying carbon credit. Many industry, if they are going for some industry, because the industry, they are supposed to, of course, they do emit the greenhouse gases, they do pollute the atmosphere. So they are supposed to have carbon credit. So they do contact the farmers, and they do advise if their technology, the minimum tillage or no tillage or row zone tillage, by having so, we can minimize the emission of carbon dioxide from the soil to the atmosphere. That is what they can have a carbon credit. So the carbon credit, they can contact the farmers, do the practice, and they can pay for the farmers. And that way the company can itself prove that though they are releasing carbon dioxide, at the same time, so they are also protecting, their minimizing loss of the dioxide from soil, the atmosphere, having these the tillage practices with so much farmers. So the farmers can get the benefit, at the same time the company gets the by the carbon credit from the farmers. This is what also going on. So the advantage other is that improving soil quality. So in case of no-till fields, often have the more beneficial insects. No, otherwise, if you, sometimes the tillage, it kills the harmful insects. At the same time, many beneficial insects are also get killed. So having the less tillage or no tillage, more of the insects, they are also protected in the soil, and protecting soil from erosion and the structural breakdown, as we discussed, and the crop residues are left intact, help both the natural precipitations and irrigation water infiltrate in the soils, reducing evaporations and conserving water. This is what we discussed now. Having the stubble mulch tillage means the that's a one type of conservation tillage when the stubbles are left on the soil surface. It's a specific tillage implement where the soil, the land is tilled at the same time the stubbles are left on soil surface. Once stubbles are left, the soil is protected from erosion. At the same time, the loss of water from the soil, the evaporation loss is checked, and of course, the rainwater infiltration is regulated. Say more infiltration of rainwater in soil having the as a stubbles, because that protect the soil from splitting, and the sealing of the soil particles is checked, or the crusting also checked if there are stubbles on the soil surface. Then the reduction tillage helps the soil aggregates from being crushed, because once you go for the conventional tillage, we are destroying soil structure. The soil structure is protected in case of the no-tillage operations. Less tillage, the soil reduces the labor and related fuel by and machinery costs. And less soil plowing means less airborne dust, because the conventional tillage, the soil pollution, the pollution, soil serious pollutant, soil pollution in the atmosphere that can protect it. So this is what are the advantages of having the conservation tillage. So this is how sustainable agriculture becomes more socially popular. Monetary grants and awards are becoming readily available for farmers who practice for the conservation tillage. Some large energy corporations, which are among the greatest generators of fossil fuel related pollutants, are willing to purchase carbon credits to encourage farmers to engage in conservation tillage. So farmers can get the benefit of from the industry. The industry can get benefit from the farmers, because they can buy the carbon credit, and they can show that though they are releasing the greenhouse gas at atmosphere through the industry, at the same time also they are purchasing carbon credit from the farmers by protecting the loss of carbon dioxide at atmosphere through conservation tillage. The farmers are the essential becomes the carbon sink of the land, because by having conservation tillage, we can have carbon sink for the power generator. So that's what the carbon credit also goes on. But however, there are some disadvantages of the conservation tillage. So sometimes it happens the yield and in case of minimum tillage or erosion tillage, yield sometimes many times you can have the lower yield as compared to conventional tillage. And this yield because of no proper technology. Because if you go for the proper technology, that means a combination of technique, equipment, pesticide, crop rotation, fertilizer and irrigation has to found which is optimal for the particular native conditions. If you have the proper technology, then yield of the conservation tillage can be as good as of conventional tillage. So that is one of the disadvantages. You have to maintain the yield. And in case of conventional tillage, yes, there's a possibility the mixing of fertilizer is well, because the manure fertilizer can be well mixed. But here it's that difficult. But you should have a proper fertilizer applicators. The fertilizer can be applied at a proper depth and can be mixed as well. And in that way, we can have the use efficiency of nutrient can be better. So that is what say the yield somehow lower, but yield can be maintained through proper technology. Now in India also, people are trying to have the no tillage. There are happy seed drill is one, where the tillage operation can be done, the seeding can be done without tillage. Even the Punjab farmers, where they are burning the rice stubbles, that has become a serious issue in case of the northern region, especially for there are many because health issues there because of burning of the rice stubbles. At the same time, pollutions, air pollutions and the health problems and also the traffic issues are there. So to avoid the burning of the paddy straw, so that's what if you do, because farmers used to burn because the paddy straws are left, the huge portions of paddy straw left, and without burning the farmers cannot go for the next operations, sowing of the next crops. But if you have tillage, the seed drills, which can sow the seeds without tillage, we can have sowing seeds. In that way, you can minimize the stubble burning. So even the stubbles are high, we don't need to till the land, and only you can go for the seed drills. Using the seed drill, the seed can sow the seeds in the inter-row areas at proper depth. That's a happy seed drill also there. There are some seed drills are coming that no tillage. Without tillage, we can go for the sowing of the seeds. That way, you can minimize the stubble burning issue as well. So that's the equipment. So there should be equipment for no-till equipments. The tillage implements should be there. There should be innovations, innovative implements which can sow the seeds at proper depth, and also at the same time you can apply fertilizers at the proper depth so that the crop should not be affected from the loss of less nutrients or for the loss of yield. So yield should be protected in conservation tillage, having the technological innovation, having the good implement, the seed drill, and the also that if the good seed drills are available, then we can go for the sowing the seeds after harvest of the previous crop without going for the tillage operations. And many a times we have seen the conservation tillage gives now better yield sometimes as compared to the conventional tillage, because the soil quality is better in case of no-till as compared to conventional tillage. Similarly, pesticides. So only disadvantage here is the other disadvantage, the pesticides. Now, there are huge application of pesticides. You have to apply pesticide to kill the weeds because you are not going for tillage operations. So that is also one of the issue because as you are not going tillage, so pesticide application, you have to go for the total killers to kill the weeds, then you can go for sowing the next crop. So this issue somehow, this has total killer like a glyphosate. That has become a serious problem in the US as well, because people are suffering from cancer disease because of the pesticide, glyphosate, total killer. So if this problem can be no-till upon as with the increased pesticide use, but traditional tillage method based on crop, so that's what is one we can take care of the weeds problem or the pest problem in case of the no-till. That is one of the disadvantages. And that can be compensated by crop rotation. Crop rotation is what? If you change the crop cycle, one crop, same crop should not be grown repeated the year after year. So if you change the crop cycle, somehow we can minimize the pest and disease and the weed problem. That way we can go for as a conservation tillage or the no-tillage. So there's a potential of the research by both institutions and the farmers continue into developing organic no-till farming. So there should be conservation tillage at the same time no-till farming method that utilize the rolling, crimping over the crops and diverse crop rotations to suppress weeds, insect and disease. Current organic farming methods often rely on excessive tillage to control these pests at the expense of soil quality. The marriage of no-till and organic has the potential to produce both healthiest food and the healthiest soil at the same time. That's what I say. So if you follow the organic farming concept, because you should not grow same crops cycle after cycle. So there should be crop rotations, one crop, different crops, so that we can somehow we can minimize the pest and disease pressures. At the same time, no tillage with the protecting the soil and protecting the environment. That is one of the need of the today's hour, because we have to minimize the global warming potentials of the agricultural productions, because now I see that agriculture also contribute to around 14% of the greenhouse gas emissions. And among them, the contribution from soil and contribution from livestock is maximum. So the major contribution comes from the livestock rearing and from the soil. So if you can minimize the emission from the soil by having no tillage or minimum tillage, or you can say conservation tillage, we can protect, we can maintain the soil health. At the same time, we must see that the production is not sacrificed. We must meet the production demand. This is what this is already there. I have loaded in this, so I think you can go through this. This is this lecture is for conservation tillage. So if you can have few questions, one or two questions, I can take the question, please.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, you mentioned about the disadvantage of this, but sir, yesterday only I was reading a few research papers. It was conducted on the yield of sesame, and they did mulching. They had a control and they used different kinds of organic mulching, and they actually found that after organic mulching, the crop yield actually increased. And sir, I also found 2 to 3 similar researches which mentioned that the yield actually increased. And sir, I also found that when mulching was done, the ground was covered, and in that way there was also less number of weeds that were produced when they did mulching. And sir, another thing, sir, instead of plowing, if we sir, it's just my question, sir. If instead of plowing, we release a lot of earthworms in the field, then can't they do the same work as which we could have achieved by plowing?
Yeah, very good. So I think I'm happy to know your response. You are right, because now if you go for mulching, because mulching is one of the resource conservation technique. And organic mulching. Organic mulching means the crop residue of the previous crop should be left over the field. But what they do mulching, they also go for the normal tillage and go for the mulching or stubble mulching. If you go stubble mulching, then stubbles are left. So these are the advantages of stubble mulching, that increases soil organic carbon content, that increases soil fertility, that increases the soil quality. In that way, yield is better. If you go for the continuous mulching, then once soil quality is improved, with less and less fertilizer, so you need to apply more fertilizer, because it protect the soil. Soil means it minimizes evaporation loss of water, increases infiltration of rainwater, irrigation water into soils, and also the mulching. Now mulching creates a soil temperature, actually that regulates soil temperature, that is very congenial for the growth of soil microbes inside and also growth of the root systems. If you see the winter, if you are going for mulching, the soil temperature remains higher than the aerial temperature. That make insulation, actually. And also in summer, if you have higher, the summer soil temperature, air temperature higher, but soil temperature remains lower by mulching. So mulching has advantages, you know, the protecting the soil health, improving soil health, and afterwards the organic mulching, they got decomposed and they add the soil quality. That's a good go for the stubble mulching. But my point is that now when you go for the minimum tillage, you go for the only dropping, you need a specialized tillage implement for minimum tillage. If your depth of sowing is proper with that implement and there are no weeds, weed growth are not there. So in case of the seed drill without tillage operations, you can have a better root system, better development. We do tillage to provide the emergence of the proper germinations, emergence and establishment of seedlings. So if you are minimum tillage, you can make a minimum disturbance for the soil while dropping the seeds and make sure that the seed is established well, then you can get the yield as good as the conventional tillage. The point is that you have to minimize the tillage operations as minimum as possible. So that is one of the approach is coming with the farm, and also that needs the tillage implements. There should be proper tillage implements so that the growth can be the emergence of seedling, establishment of seedling, initial stage. So once the seedling established, once the root growth is there, then there is a implement to apply fertilizers, because fertilizers should not be spread over the field as there is no tillage operations. There should be implement the tools which can place fertilizer proper depth. If that is done, and especially with stubble mulching, weeds can be checked. If you go for the stubble mulching, that also checks weed growth. But if you have no that mulching, you go only minimum tillage or the ozone tillage, so there will be wood growth. So stubble mulch is the best one among the tillage, conservation tillage, stubble mulching tillage, having stubbles on the field, that is the best one to conserve soil moisture at the same time to have a better soil quality for the yield. You can achieve higher yield, there's no doubt on this. That's true. Yes.
Okay, sir, and just I asked about the earthworms, right? Means
earthworm. See, earthworm, if you can release earthworm in the field, it is fine. You can release earthworm, but same as once you are not going to tillage operations, the earthworm population as such better in case of non-tillage operations. But you can go for the organic manure additions. Once you add the vermicompost contains the cocoons of earthworm. If you go on adding organic farming with no tillage, we go organic additions, that will enhance the population of earthworm in the field. So that will enhance the quality of soil as well. You can do earthworm additions and you can use organic manure.